IMUs help us accelerate recovery because they allow us to be specific on every drill, every session, and every week of training. We're also able to use the iMeasure U data to change the drills we were doing. We found certain drills were having the response that we were hoping for and other drills weren't. The whole point of measuring things is to get accurate information about what's going on. And the IMU data gives us that information in the field, in training and in competition. And therefore we can specialize every drill, every minute, every repetition and make sure that what we think is happening and ultimately plan out in detail what we need to do to get to where we need to get to. The whole challenge with rehab is engagement, and if you're not 100% bought into the process, there's a lot of time where you can just drift. And what the sensors allowed us to do was to track this athlete specifically, find out what specifically worked for him in different scenarios, and make sure that what we were doing was getting the results for the lower limb loading that we thought it was. So I think that the athlete got excited because, first of all, he could see that improvement over time. He could see these things getting better. He could see himself improving. It also gave him reassurance that what we were doing was 100% correct. That reassurance is a huge part of any sort of rehab program where confidence is always going to be a challenge. So the data provides reassurance that, yes, you physically can do this, and yes, this drill is getting out of you what you're capable of. So with women's tennis, their question was specifically around, what does training look like? What does competition look like, and how close are they? What do we need to do to our training scenario to match competition exactly? And it was a really cool project around tracking load in training, tracking load in competition. And one of the real challenges that came out was that matches in tennis aren't set. These matches shift over time and they're really opponent dependent. So having a really great understanding of what the extremes of preparedness need to be really helped shape the way we then design training following that. So one of the interesting data things that came out when measuring tennis performance was that competition is naturally quite stop and start. We had a lot of high impacts and a lot of low impacts, which is pretty intuitive when you think about it, because that's what tennis looks like. But seeing the data there and seeing that glaringly obvious stop-start nature of tennis in the data really sort of made you stop and reflect about what you're doing in training. The training data that we had was a lot more middle of the road loading, you know, a lot more longer periods of exercise, longer periods of intensity, longer periods of work. And on reflection, that didn't really represent what was being required on a competition basis. Tennis is a high impact game. Let's make training high impact. It's on or it's off. Go or it's stop.
You know, I think once you find something that works, you know, we're also very much creatures of habit when you do something works well. And so I think we've already talked with Daniel about, you know, using the information in the future and using, you know, the data and iMeasure U. Now there's a relationship with the university. There's no reason to go back to where we were before.
In an era where sports performance is getting tighter and tighter and the window for success is smaller and smaller, getting detailed understanding of performance is vital. And I wouldn't call it a game changer, but I call it a game necessity. The days of guessing what's going to happen, the days of using my intuition by itself are gone. The days of merging intuition with data are here. And if you're not doing that, you're quickly going to be left behind.